Hi student. Students, you just observe a given figure. So, look here. This is the triangle. Now, this triangle we are divided into four equal parts. And from that, one part I share here. Okay, now here the shaded portion is total parts are 4 and from that one part is shaded. So we get fraction for the shaded part 1 upon 4. So from this fraction 1 upon 4, the lower number 4 indicates the number of equal parts of a figure. The lower number 4 indicates the number of equal parts of a figure and it has been divided into. So, this number 4 we called it denominator. What we called it? Denominator of the fraction. So, one more thing you remember, the denominator never 0. And the upper number 1 indicates the number of equal parts used or referred to. It is called numerator of the fraction. What called it is? Numerator of the fraction. So, how to write this fraction? Fraction is equal to numerator upon denominator. How to write fraction? Fraction is equal to numerator upon denominator. Now, numerator means what? Equal parts being referred. And denominator means what? Total number of equal parts. Listen again. Denominator, we express total number of equal parts. And numerator, it is used for equal parts being referred to. Okay. So, let's solve exercise 2 of lesson number 2, fraction. So, look here, we have to complete the given table. So, we will see first figure. So, in this figure, so look at this figure carefully. So, in this figure, rectangles are given. Correct? And how many total number of rectangles are given here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Total number of rectangles are 10. So here total parts means denominator. So lower number which indicate the number of equal parts of a figure. Here number of equal parts of a figure are 10 and it has been divided into, it is called denominator of the fraction. So we write 10 as a denominator. Okay, and from that shaded parts, how many shaded parts are given here? Here shaded parts 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, shaded parts are 7 which indicate the number of equal parts used or referred to, means shaded parts, and it is denoted by numerator. So, here numerator is 7. So, fraction for the shaded parts 7 upon 10. We get here fraction for the shaded parts 7 upon 10. Now see next figure. Here, total parts. First, we will see total parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Total parts we represent as a denominator. So here total number of parts are 6. So we write total parts 6. Now from that, how many shaded parts are here? One part is shaded. So we write 1 as a numerator. So fraction for the shaded parts, we get 1 upon 6. Okay. Now see third figure. So here, look at this given figure. So here, how many total number of equal parts? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Total number of equal parts are 9. So we write total parts 9. From that, how many number of equal parts are shaded? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 parts are shaded. So here, shaded parts are 8. We denote as numerator, and total parts are 9. We denote as denominator. So we get fraction for the shaded parts, 8 upon 9. Okay. Now see next figure. Here, total number of circle. So we will count it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Here total number of parts are, how many are there? 14. Okay. So total parts are 40. So from that, how many shaded? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So shaded parts are 5. So we denote 5 as a numerator and 14 as a denominator. So we get fraction for the shaded part, 5 upon 14. So student, here we get fraction 5 upon 14. Now we will see next figure. So here total number of equal parts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Total number of equal parts are 8. And from that, how many shaded? 1, 2, 3. Shaded parts are 3. Means here, 3 as a numerator and 8 as a denominator. So we write fraction for the shaded part, 3 upon 8. In this way, student, we complete that table.